just wanted to highlight a stock, Nandan Denim. The stock is up 11% right now. I think there is some news flow which has come for Nandan Denim. We are trying to get the management, but if I'm not wrong, they are likely to get a tax refund of the last 10 years from the government, and probably that has taken the stock up close to about 10%. Just wanted to highlight that particular move on Nandan Denim. Let's go across to our next manager, now MD and CEO at Bajaj Allianz General Insurance is now joining us. Mr. Tapan is with us. Mr. Tapan, we understand that the third party norms would become compulsory from September 1. How positive is it for the industry, and how would you look at it on an accounting basis?
Well, let's look at two aspects of it. First is why it is happening. Second, what can be done more. And third, the impact on the industry. The reason for it is that most of the vehicles, let's say if I look at in two-wheelers, about 70-75% of vehicles on the road are uninsured. If I look at four-wheelers, it's about 20% of vehicle to 25% of vehicle would be uninsured. Commercial vehicle would be about 40% would be uninsured on the road. Now, this is an attempt to find a solution to get vehicles insured. But if I look at it for two-wheelers or four-wheelers, now we're talking about 5 years for two-wheelers and four-wheeler for 3 years. To some extent, yes, it will solve the problem. But to a larger extent still, the problem of commercial vehicles uninsured still would remain. And four-wheelers typically after the first 3 to 4 years, the uninsured percentage increases. In the first 2 to 3 years, I think about 90% of vehicles are already insured. Now, what we can do more on this is that if I look at all insurance companies, send the data to IIB. And RTUs also have the data in electronic form. Using a good data match, we can actually figure out how many vehicles are uninsured, irrespective of number of years they have been registered. And we could the RTU could send a challan, or they could send a notice to vehicle owners based on the data record of uninsured vehicles. And also the police in their apps could get the details of uninsured vehicles. So when they're inspecting, they can do that. That would solve it in a larger perspective. Now if I look at the impact on the industry from a perspective of this vehicles, if you look at the guidelines given by our regulator, it stipulates that you can have 3 year TP, 5 year TP depending on four wheeler, and you can also have OD, that's the own damage cover, for 1 year or a combined of 3 to 5 years. But the premium booked would be on year-wise basis, and the commission would be on year-wise basis. So fundamentally, if I look at the impact as such, is not huge, because you will be getting an yearly booking. But the uninsured percentage of two-wheelers in the first 5 years certainly drop, because you have a five-year cover now for TP, and for four-wheelers also would drop. So the issue which is getting addressed would get addressed to some extent, and that is a good sign. That's the way I look at this.
And if you look at the share of motor business, it's quite high as far as your company is concerned. How positive are these new norms for you then? Would we see an incrementally higher premium growth, and also how will the premium growth shape up say over the next 1, 2, 3, 4 years?
So we look at Bajaj Allianz in particular, our motor business close to 44-45% of our portfolio, which would be close to what the industry would be writing in terms of motor. And if you also look at our presence in the four-wheeler, we would be one of the market leaders in terms of the number of vehicles that we would be insuring. Now, if I look at it, so we are already a market leader. And I said in the first 3 years, four-wheelers would typically have a 90%, 95% penetration as it is. So the impact of four-wheeler business increase would be not much if I look at it, because you want to book it every year as it progresses. But a two-wheeler business, I think by the second, third year, the renewal ratio drops. So there the impact would be much bigger in terms of premium hike. So if I look at the two-wheeler portfolio, the two-wheeler portfolio would increase in the next 2 to 3 years because of this insurance which is mandatory. So overall there would be some increase, but if I look at the entire industry, the increase in terms of premium would be close to 4 to 5%. That is what the impact would be. So it's not such a huge impact that it will make a huge difference, and it is an impact for the purpose which is being done. I think we should look at it from that perspective.
Right, you know, while insurance companies play a vital role in, you know, in protecting, you know, losses of life and property. However, just from your company's perspective, would you like to give us the profit impact of the recent floods?
So, if I look at, as I told you in the past also, I think the overall impact would be close to about 100 or 150 odd crores, you know, in terms of, because you have reinsurance arrangement, and you also have, you know, a kind of layer protection which is there from a credit insurance company. And if I look at the kind of underwriting profit and the profits that we made, there would be some impact, but not a significant impact.
And broadly, what would be your growth strategy over the next couple of years, if you could highlight it for the benefit of our viewers? Do you see profit and premium growth shaping, and which are the segments that you think will lead or help you, profit more?
Okay, if I look at again in the past, I think our philosophy is clear. We want to be known as a good underwriting company. We make underwriting profits. We also are known as the innovators who bring in changes and enhance customer experiences. So we'll be continuing with that, and our ambition always has to be to grow over the market. And in the past, we have done that. So that would be our mission, to grow over the market growth rate, to remain an underwriting company which writes, understands business well, and to be a company which innovates and brings differences to customers and make a difference to their lives and be there when they require us. I think that philosophy of ours will continue doing so. But if you look at the market growth, in the first quarter, I think industry grew at close to 9% and Bajaj Allianz grew at about 23%. I think the industry combined ratio was close to 115% and Bajaj Allianz combined ratio was close to 91.2%. So if I look at, we continue on a philosophy, if you look at the product innovations we did, we were the first to bring out a cyber retail cover in the Indian market. We were one of the first to bring solutions of paying via when there's a flight delay into the customer knows, or paying on the spot for motor. So the innovation will continue. We'll be continuing enhancing customer experience, and we shall continue our philosophy of doing business the way we have been doing in the past.
Right, so thank you so much for taking our time for us and telling us about what's the impact of these changes in the motor vehicle norms, motor vehicle insurance norms, as well as the impact of Kerala. We did not have time today for Dr. C.K. Narayan to come on the show, but for